Hello, welcome to Escaping the Echo Chamber. And let's just get into it. MTG versus AOC, Marjorie Taylor Greene versus Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. That is the showdown that is looming. Now, the interesting thing is why the showdown is looming. Before we do that, I was actually going to do an earlier video on Marjorie Taylor Greene because of something that happened that I think was very unfair and disingenuous. And it was this now this production piece about her, and they spent a good portion of the, like at least a minute and a half, talking about how racist the town she grew up in is. And then like there was very little, very scant evidence of her individual racism. Now, I don't know if she's racist. I'm not vouching that she's not. But if you're going to make the claim, provide the evidence that she is racist, not the town, and then try to say, well, this town has a racist history, and so by association, and leave that inference, because that was disingenuous as hell. It was narrated by Van Lathan, but it was not written by Van Lathan. He was just the person that wrote the narrated the whatever it was, the production. But aside from that, aside from the fact that I think there is an overzealousness and this desire to paint, just basically to marginalize her, and so to dismiss her so that nobody pays attention to anything she does or says. Oh, she's racist. Okay, so now that invalidates her, and they don't actually have to work to defend their ideas or provide genuine critiques of hers, which is really, really interesting. Because a lot of her ideas are absolutely horrible. Like the fact that she was arguing that it's against the law, it's against the law to swear in on a Quran shows, like, never mind her support of the January 6th protesters. That is the reason why I would have not put her on any committees. I would have pulled her off committees. Like, if you're that ignorant of the law, like you're it's malpractice. It's legislative malpractice to have this woman dealing with actual being on any committees. It technically would be should be considered legislative malpractice for her to be in Congress at all, but she was voted in. If that's what the people want, that's what the people get. If they want somebody that knows nothing, absolutely nothing, just like the president, about law or about their job, that's their choice, and they do so at their own peril. But yeah, I would have, pulled her off committees just because she's just absolutely ignorant of actual law and policies and proceed. Like, it's ridiculous how the idiocy of this woman. But now what we come to here is her challenging AOC to a debate. What is the debate on? The debate is on the Green New Deal. So she challenges AOC to the debate, and then she says, oh yeah, as soon as I get to read the Green New Deal, the 14 pages, in the week, like I said, then we'll debate. Number one, it's going to take you a week to read 14 pages. Wow, this woman is dumb. But what's even, like, you've spent months talking about how horrible the Green New Deal is, how bad it is, how bad these policies are, how horrible they are for America, and you haven't read the, like, you haven't even read the bill, you haven't read the proposal, you haven't read the resolution, you haven't read anything, you haven't, but just you're arguing about how bad it is. This Marjorie Taylor Greene, for all her stupidity, is a symptom. She's a symptom of basically of where we're at as a country, because that is, she is not the only person to do some stupid stuff like that. I routinely see people arguing about stuff that they have no knowledge of. They will argue against a policy that they're not, they have done no research into. They will say, oh, this law is bad, and they haven't read the law. What are they going on? Somebody else told them. And they will say with 100% certainty, as if they, like, it's Dunning-Kruger to, like, that's the epidemic. Never mind COVID. Dunning-Kruger has got to be the most infectious disease on the planet right now, especially at least in the country, because I routinely see it. People will argue something, blah 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 blah, and like, yes, this is horrible. This is and you support this, and I'm like, well, you know, it says this and this. No, it doesn't. Like, yeah, it does. And I'll actually show them the portion of whatever it is. And they're like, well, that's it. I'm like, wait a minute. Did you actually read it? Like, where are you getting this information from? Because now I'm starting to suspect you didn't actually read what you spent so much energy, time, and devoted so much passion to critiquing. You haven't even read it. Case in point, somebody decided to criticize me today on a video that on my live stream from yesterday about how I was making excuses and trying to making excuses for against the cop, you know, against the cop in Columbus, Nicholas Reardon. And I'm like, the first statement he made is like, oh yeah, you're just trying to avoid common sense. And I'm like, wait a minute, maybe I misunderstood what this person is saying. I'm like, how so? He's like, oh yeah, because you're trying to, the cop is a hero. And I'm like, okay, wait a minute. Did you actually watch my video? Because if you watched my video, if you watched my live stream, I wasn't as forceful in my live stream as I was in the video I posted today, but I made it pretty clear that, like calling him a murderer is absolutely ridiculous. And that he saved the girl's life. He saved the girl in pink's life. But yet this person formed an opinion, offered a critique about a video, a live stream, they hadn't even seen. And that's just, it's so telling on where we are and why things are so screwed up. Because people are that stupid these days that they will run off. They will run off full bore on something that they know nothing about, will defend it, will fight for it. And then you say, well, do you know what you're fighting for? No, they don't. But they're ready to just go off on people. They're ready to, you know, tear shit up, and they have no clue what they're even fighting for. But that's where we're at. That's why we have somebody like Marjorie Taylor Greene. She's not alone in this. She's a symptom of, I mean, people, it's like people appreciate that level of ignorance. They love it. And so it's why we're doomed as a society, as a planet, as humanity is doomed as long as, you know, this sort of idiocy reigns supreme. Thank you for checking out this episode of Escape the Echo Chamber. As always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And as always, I will see you next time.